Now it's time to talk about the other bugaboo that you find in your pond during the spring and summer, during the heat of the summer especially. You're going to find string algae growing in your pond. It's filamentous algae. It just means that the algae is linked together and made a filament that looks like a string or a hair that's growing off the rock. This pond doesn't have any of that left on it. She says it has had during earlier times, but she's treated for it and taken care of it. It also shows that the pond remains in balance. She's got the right number of fish with the right amount of water with the right amount of bacteria. So those are the things that you've got to think about. Balance in your pond. String algae, if it's growing on your rocks, is really healthy for your pond. It's a biofilm, and that's where that bacteria colony lives. We can get into a lot of science about the bacteria and what's going on and why you shouldn't remove it, but just let me say that we think to go in and clean your pond once a year and power wash it is the wrong thing to do. You wind up wiping out a huge bacteria colony that you've spent a long time building up. And that bacteria colony is what's going to keep that algae that grows on the rocks from growing strings and turning into that hair-like or string algae that you hate so much. There are products, oxygenators, that you can put on your pond that are granule. You pour them on the algae and then wash it off, and that'll kill the algae and remove most of it from the rock. But you have to understand that you're living the pond life. You are going to have some algae in your pond. That's probably the good news. Everybody has algae. The bad news is that you can't get rid of the algae. The good news is that you can manage the algae by doing a few things. For string algae, what you want to do if it gets real bad is get in there and get some of it out. A lot of folks will take a brand new toilet brush. I emphasize it's a brand new toilet brush. Tie it on the end of a stick and then use that and twirl it around to get that long hair algae out of the water. I don't find that very efficient. We usually just use our hands and get down on our knees and pull it out so we can take out big bunches of it if it grows. But if you start soon enough, you're not ever going to let it get to that point. So check your balance, look at your filters all the time and make sure they're clean. Make sure that you're trapping as much of the nutrient as you can. If you have a pond vac or a shop vac and can clean the bottom of your pond, that's going to go a long ways in keeping that string algae from growing in the water. You're not going to have as much problem with it if you can keep the nutrient at bay. Too many fish, too much nutrient, sunlight, and water is a recipe to grow algae, both single cell and string. The string is the one that comes with the heat of the summer, and that's what most people dislike, is the string algae growing in there. They think it makes it look ugly. I think it makes it look natural. That's a personal opinion. Everybody's got one. They're like noses. Some of them are more pointed than others. So enjoy your pond, enjoy the time with it, and do some simple things like water changes, cleaning your filter, cleaning the muck out of the bottom, before you get to the point where you have to start treating it with costly chemicals. Once you start that process, you're probably going to have to keep it up because you're killing the algae. It's going to disintegrate. It's going to sink to the bottom, create more of that muck. That muck creates nutrient. That nutrient in the water causes an imbalance. That imbalance is what you're fighting against. So that's what we're all about, is trying to figure out how to balance your pond correctly so that it doesn't cost you a lot of time or a lot of money.
We hope you enjoyed this video. It's part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on our OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.